After a few weeks, the furnishings in his room began to fade away and disappear, until at last there was nothing left but the armchair, the table, the paper, and his inkstand. What is more, the walls of the room became encrusted with lime, and the floor with a yellow glaze. The Langfans' own clothes were now much coarser. He wondered at these changes, but he went on writing about faith while denying charity, and was so persistent in this exclusion that he was suddenly transported underground to a kind of workhouse, where there were other theologians like him. Locked up for a few days, Melanchthon fell to doubting his doctrine and was allowed to return to his former home. He was now clad in a hairy skin. He tried hard to convince himself. What had just happened to him was no more than a hallucination. He went back to extolling faith and the lifting charity. One evening, Melanchthon felt cold. He began examining the house and soon discovered that the other rooms no longer matched those of his old house in the natural world. One was cluttered with instruments whose use he did not understand, and another had shrunk so small that entrance was impossible. The third had not changed, but its doors and windows opened onto vast sandbanks. One of the rooms at the back of the house was full of people who worshipped him, and who kept telling him that no theologian was ever as wise as he. And these praises pleased him. But since some of the visitors were faceless, and others seemed dead, he ended up hating and distrusting them. It was at this point that he decided to write something concerning charity. The only difficulty was that what he wrote one day, he could not see the next. This was because the pages had been written without conviction. Melanchthon received many visits from persons newly dead, but he felt shame at being found in so run-down a lodging. In order to have them believe he was in heaven, he hired a neighboring magician, who tricked the company with appearances of peace and splendor. The moments his visitors were gone, and sometimes a little before, these adornments vanished, leaving the house with a form of plaster and draftiness. The last I heard of Melanchthon was that the magician and one of the faceless men had taken him away into the sandhills, where he is now a kind of servant of demons.